Hello everyone. So today I'll be talking about anticipation of invention. Again, this is from a standpoint of preparation for the patent agent examination, but since I'll be discussing the general concepts, you may also be able to apply these in your general practice. So if you see in section 2.1L, it defines a new invention, which means any invention or technology which has not been anticipated by publication in any document, which means that it should not have been published in any document or maybe used somewhere in the public domain prior to the filing of the patent application for that particular invention. And that publication or use could have happened in India or it could have happened anywhere outside India. Thereafter, you will find a reference to anticipation in section 13, which provides that the examiner conducts a search for anticipation by way of prior publication or by prior claiming when he conducts an examination of your application under section 12 of the Patents Act. So very broadly, the controller or the examiner searches that your invention has not been anticipated by way of a previous publication which may have happened in India or maybe outside India before the date of filing of your application for that invention. So this is what I have summarized here. Section 13, the examiner conducts a search for checking out if your invention has been anticipated. So this is a part of the examination process that the examiner conducts under section 12. And broadly, under this examination, he checks if the claimed invention is anticipated by a prior publication in any patent specification that has been filed in India, or it may have been anticipated by any claim of a prior filed application, but which was published after your patent application, or your invention is checked to find out if it is anticipated by a prior publication that happened in India or elsewhere in any document. However, not all types of anticipation could be considered as damaging the novelty of your innovation. So there are certain exceptions that are provided under the Patents Act. So here I'll be just providing you with brief summaries of all the sections. I would request you to kindly read through the Patents Act and read all these sections in detail to understand what these intend to say. So section 29 takes care of a situation where the invention was taken from the patentee or the inventor or maybe the owner of the invention, but it was published without their consent. And the patentee or the applicant filed the patent application as soon as they came to know about the publication that happened without their consent. However, there is one proviso to this particular section. It says that the invention should not have been commercially worked in India by the patentee or any person who has been authorized by them with their consent. So if the invention was commercially worked, then it would be considered as anticipation by prior publication. In all other cases, if the invention has been published without their consent and they made a patent application as soon as they came to know about the publication, then it won't be considered as an anticipation. Also, in case of a patent application that has been made by a true and the first inventor, there would be no anticipation by a prior filed application which has been made in contravention of the inventor's rights. So in a way, someone stole the rights of the inventor or maybe did not give due credit to the inventor's rights and filed a patent application. That patent application would not anticipate a patent application that has been later filed by the true and the first inventor. Section 30 deals with anticipation by previous communication to government. So in the event that the innovators have communicated their invention to the government so as to investigate the merits of the invention, maybe to carry out some testings which are statutorily required or for some regulatory approvals, then that communication to the government would not anticipate the patent application that has been filed after making that communication to the government. Section 31 deals with exceptions to anticipation by way of public display. So there would be no anticipation in case the invention has been displayed in an exhibition that has been notified by the central government, or maybe if there is a publication of description of the invention pursuant to that particular display in the exhibition. Maybe there are pamphlets that have been circulated, so that wouldn't be considered as an anticipation. Then a non-consensual use of the invention after the display, so someone uses it without the consent of the owners of the invention, so that would not be considered as an anticipation. And then description of an invention in a paper read by the inventor before a learned society. So you disclose your invention before a learned society in some transactions of the society, or maybe you publish a paper related to your invention in the journal of that society. It won't be considered as an anticipation, provided within 12 month period of displaying your invention in that exhibition or maybe reading out a paper before a learned society, you need to file that patent application for that invention which you covered in that exhibition or the paper. So if you do that, your patent application would not be anticipated by your previous actions of displaying it in the exhibition or maybe reading out a paper before the learned society. Section 32 provides exceptions to anticipation by way of public working. So sometimes for some inventions, it is required that you need to conduct a reasonable trial before the public so as to identify whether that invention is feasible or not. So if you are doing that for the purpose of reasonable trial and it is being done by the patentee or any authorized person who has been authorized by the patentee or the owner of the invention, then it won't be considered as an anticipation in the event that reasonable trial has been conducted 1 year before the priority date of the invention or whenever you file the first application. So the reasonable trial should not have been conducted more than 1 year before the first application that you file. So section 33 provides exceptions to anticipation by use of the invention after you file the provisional application. So in the event you use the invention after you have filed the provisional application, it won't be considered as an anticipation for any complete specification that you file at a later stage for that same provisional application. Let us now understand this by taking an example. So I have taken question 7 from paper 2 of the 2018 patent agent examination paper. So what you need to do to approach a problem like this is to read it first and try and understand all the facts. So now what I have done is I have marked all the different facts in different colors so as to enable you to understand what are the different facts that are involved. Very briefly, what it says is that Mr. Datta has developed an invention which is a watch, and what he has done is he has approached the central government to get a financial grant for his invention, and thus he shared that invention with an official of the government. Then he exhibited his invention in an industrial fair that has been organized by the government of India, and that was done on 15th February 2015. At the same time, what one of his colleagues did was he published the invention in one of the leading newspapers, but that was done without his consent. So now this is a very important aspect of this fact. So I told you about the different exceptions to anticipation. So now you have to read the facts in view of those exceptions that are there. So if you would remember, non-consensual publication would not be considered as an anticipation, provided there are some certain conditions for that. So then what is given is he attended awareness program at the patent office, came to know about his rights, and then immediately filed a provisional application on 10th of March. So he attended the program on 5th of March and then immediately filed a provisional application to cover that invention. But now he is worried whether his provisional application would be anticipated by whatever previous publication has been done or maybe the communication that has been sent to the central government. So the question asks you to advise your client. So now you are acting as a patent agent and you have to advise your client as to what he needs to take care of and whether all these previous publications or displays or whatever communication that he has sent, would that hamper his application that he has filed before the patent office. So to answer this, what you'll do is you'll take each fact one by one and then explain to your client whether he's covered under any of the provisions of the Patents Act or not. So coming first to the communication to the government, you'll have to refer to section 30. You'll have to write in your answer what section 30 provides and then how this fact falls into the provisions of that particular section. So you'll have to tell your client that you have disclosed it to the central government and this was just to get an approval for financial grant, and thus this falls within the provisions of section 30. Your communication to the central government or the official would not be considered as an anticipation. Coming next to the display in the exhibition, again you will have to refer to section 31 and then say that the display in the exhibition that has been notified by the government or in the official gazette is exempted and would not be considered as an anticipation. So you'll have to ask your client, because here the information that is given is that the industrial fair was organized by the government. It could be deemed to be that this industrial fair was advertised in the official gazette, but since the facts do not specify that, you cannot assume it. You'll have to ask your client that maybe the client can confirm whether this industrial fair was notified somewhere in the official gazette so that the provisions of section 31 apply to this particular display. So you'll have to explain section 31 first and then say that the provisions of this would be utilized only when the central government has extended the provisions to this exhibition under section 31. So you'll have to ask your client that way you confirm whether this exhibition was notified by the government or not. If you remember, section 31 provides that even if it has been displayed in an exhibition which has been notified by the central government, you need to file the patent application within a period of 12 months of that display. So now what he has done is he has filed the application within the 12 month period that has been provided in section 31. So what you can advise to him is that your public display in that exhibition would not be considered as an anticipation, since you filed a patent application within that 12 month period from that display, provided the exhibition was covered under section 31 and it was notified by the central government that provisions of section 31 would apply to this exhibition. As regards the publication by the colleague, which is without his consent, so again you can tell him that this was a publication that happened without his consent. The facts provide that he attended an awareness program, and as soon as he came to know about his rights on 5th of March, he immediately filed a provisional application on 10th of March. So now this could be considered as a reasonable time period when he became aware of his right, and so he filed a provisional application in a reasonable time period. So thus it falls under section 29, and thus it would not be considered as an anticipation. So what I've done is I've just summarized all these points here. So these are the four pointers that you would need to take care of while advising your client. So as I said, you go fact-wise and then apply the different provisions of section 29 to section 33 and see which provision applies to your facts, and then advise your client accordingly. In case you have any questions, please drop them in the comments box and I'll be happy to answer those. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel so that you get regular updates regarding further videos that I'll be posting on different aspects of the Patents Act and how to answer questions regarding the Patents Agent examination. Thank you very much.